dear brothers and sisters, the Lord is with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory be to O Lord. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and considered in her mind what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of the kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no husband?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your kinswoman Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month with her, who was called barren. For with God, nothing will be impossible." And Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be done to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, I would like to tell you the great biography of Saint Agnes. Saint Agnes, who was born in the 3rd century, somewhere around 291, and she's the one who was just 13 years old. She was beautiful, she was rich, she was talented, and she came from some sorts of a royal family. And so because of the beauty, there are a lot of young boys who really wanted to get married to her. But unfortunately, she did not want to marry anyone. And finally, some son of a prefect of the country, who also proposed to her, and she also said no to him. So all these young boys from the prominent families, and also this son of this prefect, they all thought that we would complain to the king that she has become Christian, so she is to be punished, and punished by just being imprisoned in some sorts of jail. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, the king took it very seriously, and he called her and then she was punished as she did not agree to get married, or she did not also want to reconvert herself in the other religion. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, these people who wanted to take revenge, they were very happy. And finally, what happened was that, to be in short, that these people who wanted her to marry them, so he refused, she refused. And because of that, they told the king to punish her, but they themselves were punished because all of them were struck blind. And the son of this prefect, who really was very angry and was really want to take some revenge on her, he died on the spot. But because of her compassion and mercy, she pleaded God and she brought him to life. So amazing. But my dear brothers and sisters, the king punished her so much that she was dragged naked in the public street. And at that moment, she prayed to God. And the miracle took place that she got very long hair, and that hair covered her whole body, and she could not be seen naked. So things happened because of her total commitment to God, because she wanted to offer her virginity to God alone. And she loved God so much, she loved Jesus so much. And this was the early Christian days, just the end of the 3rd century. And my dear brothers and sisters, you can think of these things. It's mainly because of her intimacy with Jesus. Now, what I want to tell you today from the reading that we have today, the first reading and also the gospel, is that first, acknowledge your own humble beginning. Now, in the first reading, we see how David was just a shepherd, a young boy. So he was not even considered in any way to be a big leader and big king. So that was his humble beginning, but he loved God and he understood the word meaning of shepherd, and he loved his sheep, and so much so that he offered his whole life for the sheep. And there are events and there are incidents how he really was belonging to God and God alone. In the case of Mary, my dear brothers and sisters, Mary was a young girl, a virgin, from a simple village of Galilee, also called Nazareth. So that was her very simple life. She never even thought she would be a mother of God. But they themselves, both these people, really were in love with God and really wanted to commit themselves to God. My dear brothers and sisters, we can say that once we know our humble beginning, we should also avail ourselves, be available for God's use. And in the case of these both, for example, David was a simple boy, did not know anything, he just played some sorts of instrument. But he said, I will be always available for God, because God has given me joy, happiness, and God has really made me me. So he was always available, and he told God, use me as you want. And the same case with Mary. So Mary also said, I am the handmaid of God. Let it be done according to your will. So she just did what God wanted her to do. Even things were difficult when she knew if I just remained pregnant, perhaps my own husband-to-be, that is Joseph, or the other people, what will they think of me? And they will stone me to death. But she said, let it be done to me according to your word. So she was ready to offer herself for God's use. And God wanted to use her to bring the Son of God to this world in human flesh. My dear brothers and sisters, we must always know that whatever we have and whatever we are, we must always use that to honor God in our own lives. So all our resources should be used for God's honor. And that is what these two people have done. David used all his talents for God's purpose. And God knew that he would use that. So he used God for all things that God had asked him to. Even Mary, in our case here, we can see, for example, that Mary said, when I am the handmaid of the God, she offered herself totally in order to honor and respect God and his word. Even in that case, David, when he became king, all the resources that he had, he wanted to build the temple of God. That my God should not live in a simple tent. There was a tent in which they were carrying this tabernacle. So he wanted to build a huge temple. But God did not want him, so he stopped. But he has used all the resources, all the money and gold and all the power and people that he wanted to use only for building the temple of God. Mary also used her whole life for Jesus. Even the time when she was asked to leave and go to Egypt, she just left. When she was asked to come back, she just came, not knowing what would happen on the road and what will happen there in Bethlehem. She did not know. Yet she offered herself for God's will. My dear brothers and sisters, what is important here is just believe in God and things would happen, everything successfully in your own life. And that is what David did. He believed in the power of God, he believed in the creation of God, and he always thought God can do mighty things. And so even when there was a lion, he could kill the lion. There was a time when he was asked to fight against Goliath, the huge army man. He just used his string and he killed him. Because he wanted to use all his power and skills only for the people of God, that is Israel, and as God wanted him to use. And he said, in the name of God, I can kill you, Goliath. And he did. So, my dear brothers and sisters, if you have faith, you can do mighty things. Mary also had faith. And Mary was ready to face all the challenges of the community. Even they had to accuse her. At the time also when Jesus was on the cross, she has to bear all the pain and suffering because she knew that she believed in God and whatever he does will be always in her favor. So in that pain and suffering, she accepted the death of Jesus, her own son. My dear brothers and sisters, at this moment, what I want to tell you, that this is the fourth Sunday. We are very close to Christmas. And this is the time when we are told how to have our faith in Jesus, our Savior, and ready to die with him, even if time demands. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, all these three or four things that I tell you, that you must always acknowledge our humble beginning, then you must avail ourselves for God's use. God can use you for anything, but you must be ready. Even if it causes suffering, you will. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, what is more important here is, if you are the person whom God loves and the one whom God loves you, then things can become the best in your life. Ask God today to send us Jesus as the Savior and Jesus as my own personal Savior.